Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to design a hybrid layout using Cricut Design Space. And I'm going to be using the Thunder Railroad bundle from Kelly Bell Designs. And first I have opened a canvas on Design Space and hit upload. And now I'm going to hit browse from upload image. And I have all of my files in downloads, and so once it comes up, I have lots of files in my download. Once the folder comes up, I'm going to start with the Thunder Railroad alphabet, and I want to upload all of my letters for my title, which is Big Thunder. So I'll start with that B. I will hit continue and apply and continue. I want to use flat graphic because that is going to help me print and cut. And I don't want to save it, but I am going to hit upload and the B will appear on my canvas. And so I'm going to go ahead and upload the rest of my letters, and this is going to be my title. So obviously these come to canvas fairly large, so I'm just going to make them a little bit smaller to get them out of the way so that I can start to arrange them. And once I have done that, then I will continue on with my layout. There are quite a few letters. However, the benefit to this is that once I have designed them here and I've moved them around, I can group them so that I'm moving the word around rather than printing and cutting them and then trying to figure out where I want them to be. So now I'm going to show you how to make your photo mats. So I have chosen the square in shapes and I'm going to unlock the size, and my photos are 3.5 inches by 3.5 inches. So I'm going to make this photo mat 3.75 by 5.75. And because I have three photos that I know I'm going to use, I'm going to duplicate this twice so that I have my photo mats, so that I have an idea of where I want my photo placement to be on my layout. Now, one thing I'm doing here is I am changing the color of those photo mats. You don't have to do that. This is just simply for my benefit. I know I want them to be black, and so I'm just changing the color of them over there. So I have them over there. I'm going to move my layouts. I know originally I wanted my layout or my title to be up at the top. Originally I thought maybe I wanted the word big up at the top and thunder down at the bottom. And so that's kind of what I'm doing here. I'm just shuffling some things around and trying to figure out where I want them and kind of what size. Now you'll see up at the top of Canvas there is a ruler. I know that my layout is going to be 12 inches by 12 inches, and so I know that I need these elements to fit within that size, and that is another benefit to kind of pre-designing it. I know that everything that I cut is going to be the right size and it's going to fit. There's nothing more frustrating than cutting something out and it not being the right size and having to go back and do that. And so this will hopefully eliminate that for you. Also, you kind of have an idea of the elements that you want and the things that you don't. So I'm going to go ahead and put that up there and work on the word thunder. So I'm going to move those around. Like I said, I thought originally I wanted big to be at the top and thunder to be at the bottom. And then once I kind of started looking at the various embellishments, I decided that wasn't exactly what I wanted. But I am going to go ahead and line these up and get them the same size. And you can do it this way, or you can do it just like I did the photo mats. You can change the size of them up there where it says size. So that's okay. I'm just kind of eyeballing it. I don't mind if they're just slightly a little bit different, but I am just going to eyeball and get them approximately the same size, and that's okay. I don't mind. And honestly, I think sometimes it can be fun to have them a little bit different size. So now I'm going to move that R down, and once I have that down, I'll show you how to group them. So I have them together. I'm going to highlight all of the letters together, and then I'm going to hit the group button. So once I've hit that, then I can move them around, and I can also change the size, and it's going to change all of the size together rather than trying to do that individually. You can stretch them, you can compress them, so you can just do a lot of different things with them. So I noticed that that I is really big, and I apologize, when I was filming this, for some reason my computer kind of glitched, and it made the I really small, so I'm going to have to resize a little bit. So I'm going to highlight, I'm going to group, and then I'm able to move that around. So then as I'm kind of moving this around and doing my letter shuffle, I thought, well, maybe I want my entire title to be down at the bottom. Maybe I want my photos up there. But I'm also going to group my photo mats so that they're all going to move together as well. And I wanted to make sure that they all are going to fit within that 12 by 12 space. So this is another way that I can move that around and make sure that my photos are going to fit the way I want them to. So that is what I'm doing. So I really wanted to play on the word big. So I did definitely want that big to be larger than the word thunder. And so I'm doing that. I have it down at the bottom. I am going to go ahead and move it up to the top here in a minute. I'm just kind of looking at it, and I decide, you know, I'm going to upload some more images. So I'm browsing. I don't want any more of the alphabet. So I'm going to pull up another one of the folders, and all of these come in the bundle, which I will link to, but you can also purchase some of these individually. So I thought maybe I wanted some page starters, and they are available as well, but I decided after looking at them, you know, that's not really going to work for what I want. So I'm going to go back to downloads and see if I can't find some other things to go on my page. So I saw that there are elements, and so I'm going to look there, and you can see there's a preview of some of the other parts of the kit. But on this, it has a lot of the really fun little things, like I know I want that cactus. So once again, I'm going to upload, continue, apply and continue, flat graphic and continue, and then upload. And it is going to put that cactus right there on my canvas. So I can move it around, and I can resize it, and I can make as many as I want. But apparently my computer was being kind of slow. So, but by the magic of editing, there I have all of those parts of the kit that I want. So I'm going to kind of resize some of them so that I can get a better look at them. I really, really, really love that goat. I just have to tell you, it is so cute. I love that there are a lot of different options for the railroad ties. There's a circular one. There's this one. I just thought that it was great that there are so many options for you. And I also noticed, you know, you can use these for Disney layouts. You can also use them for regular layouts. We just went on a train ride not too long ago, and I can use that train track. I can use those flowers. I can use some of the other things that aren't Big Thunder specific. That's one of the great things about digital elements, is that you can use them for a lot of different things that they're not specific for Disney. So I have my track there. I know I want it to go somewhere down at the bottom. Spoiler alert, that tag is not going to make the final cut. But I am pretty happy about this mountain goat. But that mountain goat may also make a debut on one of my other layouts as well. I have gone to Idaho a couple of years ago, and there were mountain goats up on the mountains. And for someone from the Midwest, we don't see a lot of mountain goats. And so I think I took a lot of pictures of that. So I have a feeling I'm going to be using that again. And I was looking at that dynamite. Now, spoiler alert, the dynamite is not going to make it on my final page either. I could have used it in lieu of the eye in big. I did not. But looking at it now as I'm doing this voiceover, I'm like, oh, you know what? That would have been a great idea. And you can certainly do that. Those are always options. And once you upload them, you can either, if you decide not to print and cut them, you can just hit that delete button or you can just hide them. You can save all of these elements into My Stuff so that they're always there. They're grouped by kit. But I'm going to go ahead and move the railroad tracks and kind of decide where I want some things to go. One of the other features in Design Space, you'll see there at the top, there's an arrange, there's a flip button, and you can change the orientation of that digital element from the kit. And that's what I did here with this cactus. When you hit that arrange, you can move it to the front, you can move it to the back, you can move it in front of a few things. You can resize it, and I decided I really did not want it over to the right. I am going to move it. That little mountain goat will end up flipping orientation as well. The dynamite, I can change it. I can make it thinner, I can make it fatter. I just really love that you have so much flexibility with these kits. You can, like I've said before, you can make them. You can resize them, and once you buy the kit, it's yours. So you can make as many. If you want two, you can make two. If you want 200, you can make 200. Those options are always there for you, which I think is a great thing. So now I'm going to continue to work on my clusters, and while I am doing that, I want you guys to help me decide a debate. So we went to Disneyland not too long ago, back last fall, and that was the first time we had ever gone to Disneyland because we are Disney World people. Like I said, I live in the Midwest. Florida is closer to me than going out to the West Coast. So, from someone who has always gone to World, we thought that Disneyland was going to be kind of a carbon copy of like Magic Kingdom. I was wrong. Obviously, Disneyland is not just a carbon copy. It is its own place. It's got some uniqueness. Some of the rides are very unique. From watching a show on Disney Plus, I understand Big Thunder at Disneyland actually came second. So here's the debate. Here's the controversy, you guys. Which one is better? I am almost a little bit ashamed to say that I think that Big Thunder in Disneyland is better. And I never thought I would say that, but it absolutely felt longer. It was fun. You have the dynamite that goes off. There's a lot of things that go on at Disneyland that I thought were better, and I never thought I would say that. So these pictures that I'm going to be doing in part two of this video series are from Disney World, and it certainly is a great ride. Don't get me wrong, I love Big Thunder Mountain at Disney World. It is a must ride for us every time we go. But I kind of like the one at Land a little bit better. So you guys tell me in the comments what you think. Let's vote. Let's decide which one is better. So there's that. So now I have my cactus in the place I want. I have my railroad tracks in the place I want. We need a few little flowers, right? It's one of my layouts. It's probably going to have some flowers on there. So I'm going to resize them to kind of go with this cute little cactus. There are a lot of different flowers in this kit. I decided to go with these, which are in several of the kits, something similar to this design, and I absolutely love these flowers. They are so adorable. And I love that you can use them for so many things. So I have the leaves, I'm going to go ahead and flip them around so that they work. I wouldn't necessarily have to do this. If you wanted to do this quickly, you could certainly just make the two that you want and know that those are going to go there. For demonstration purposes, I went ahead and showed you just kind of the whole process, but you don't have to do that. You don't have to send it to the back. You can just add them and kind of throw them in the area where you think you want them to go. But I'm going to go ahead and do the whole thing for you just so that you can see the whole process. So now that we have had the Big Thunder debate, let me know if you have any questions about hybrid scrapbooking, right? Like, if you're like me, I have traditionally done just paper layouts. The digital world is kind of a new thing for me, but I am absolutely loving that I have options with hybrid scrapbooking. And part of that is because we do go to the parks a lot. We are DVC members, so we go to the parks. I wish that we were annual pass holders. That would be pretty awesome. But we do go to the parks at least a couple times a year. And so I have a lot of Disney albums that I work on. And there's only so many products out there. The thing that I love about these digital kits are that it opens up a whole other world of supplies. So if you are a Disney supply collector, let's call us collectors, we're not hoarders, we're collectors, you have more options, and I love that. And like I was saying before, you don't necessarily have to use them just for Disney, but it does expand the options that you have. And I love that that is the case. I love that I can print and cut them. And I love that it's kind of an economical option. And one thing that I really, really love about Kelly Bell is that there are a lot of freebies within the group. If you are playing along in the Rediscover Your Stash Facebook group, we're doing a spending freeze this month. I am doing terribly on that, by the way. But you can try out some of the free elements. I will link in the description to some of the Facebook fan group and the store page and the store website. And so you can check them out. So if you're a little bit like, Shannon, I don't know if this is the kind of scrapbooking that I feel comfortable with, you can try it out. And also, if you check out my video from Festival of the Arts, I am this month giving away a $10 gift card to the store. So check it out. Try a hybrid layout and tag me and let me see what you come up with. I would love to see it. And if you have any questions, of course, just let me know. So I'm working on my title again, and I decided that it just needed something up here. And I really like this little lantern. I think it's super cute. So I'm moving things around, and I'm glad that I decided to do that because, as you can see, adding that lantern, I'm going to have to resize those letters again. If I had cut those letters beforehand, it kind of limits what I could do. It wasn't going to fit, or I'd have to move them around my page. So this gives me the opportunity to make sure that it all fits on there. And so once I am done with that, then I'm going to show you the print and cut process. So if you're not used to using print and cut on your Cricut, this is how you do it. So I have my layout basically done. I don't have the pattern paper and all of that printed out, although in this bundle, there is digital paper as well. So I'm going to hit make. I'm not going to go ahead and save this project right this second, but you do have that option, and then it's in your stuff. Once you pull that up, like I said, my computer was being super slow. It shows you how it's going to print. You hit continue. Once you hit continue and send to printer, it is going to pull up what it's going to look like, what it's printing. It'll pull up, it'll connect to your printer, and then you hit print. Once you hit that print button, it's going to print off what you see there. And once it prints, then you put it on your photo mat, you line it up, and I like to use the cardstock for intricate cuts. I do like to print on smooth cardstock, and I think it gives a really nice feel. You can use other elements as well. And then once you do that, there's your final print. So thanks again for checking out my channel, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.